is asking, why can't women call out loud adhan and iqama? Before I answer the question, we all have to understand that al-ibadatu tawqifiyya. The word tawqifiyya means that we stop at the commandment of Allah the Almighty without asking for a validation or an explanation or a reason or the wisdom behind prescribing dhuhr at noon, asr after noon, maghrib after sunset. Why? You don't ask these questions. Because the wisdom of making maghrib 3 rak'ahs versus fajr 2 rak'ahs, and you recite out loud in this and secretly in this, this is purely divine. So you do as you are commanded, and this is basically the meaning of worship. But you can ask, what is the purpose of the prayer? Well, the Quran is full of references. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Because the prayer will stop the person from indulging into illicit relations and committing sins and so on. أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِدُلُوكِ الشَّمْسِ إِلَى غَسَقِ اللَّيْلِ وَقُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ إِنَّ قُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا. Surah Al-Isra. It tells us the purpose of praying on different intervals. Also, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ وَزُلَفًا مِّنَ اللَّيْلِ إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَى لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. Surah Hud. It explains that offering the prayers on regular times expiate sins which were committed in between and so on. But to ask Allah, why Maghrib 3 rak'ahs? Why do I have to call Adhan this way and not that way? This is out of the question. It's exactly pretty much similar to asking your doctor. You said, I have to take this medication before meal and this after meal and this within the meal. Why? Because I'm a doctor. I know the drug-drug interaction. I know the absorption. I know the best method of administration. So that's why I'm a doctor. You know, and I prescribe the medication. You're a patient. And I don't owe an explanation to every patient, right? So the Almighty Allah, يَتَعَبَّدُنَا, tests our servitude through commanding us. Then when we obey, that's called worship. The Prophet ﷺ ordered us to beautify our voices whenever we're calling adhan and iqama. And when Abdullah ibn Zayd saw the dream of the adhan and he came to the Messenger of Allah, he said, عَلِّمْهُ بِلَالًا فَإِنَّهُ أَنْدَى مِنْكَ صَوْتًا. Go and teach Bilal how to call this adhan which you saw in your night vision. إِنَّهُ أَنْدَى مِنْكَ صَوْتًا. Because he has a melodious voice. His voice is better than yours. So in this case, while women were commanded not to raise their voices, فَلَا تَخْضَعْنَا بِالْقَوْلِ فَيَطْوَمَعَ الَّذِي فِي قَلْبِهِ مَرَضٍ. That's why women don't sing. That's why women do not recite the Quran with a beautiful melodious voice in public, right? Likewise, in the case of Adhan. And this is simply an explanation which Allah doesn't owe us. So we follow and we do not innovate. We follow and we do not question Allah's judgment and the wisdom behind every act. And Allah knows best.